Hello YouTube. In this video I'm going to paint an example of a shield. I'm going in this example for the red ones, and for that I'm going to use Dumbledore Brown. I really like this color for the shields. I painted also some other Lizardman shields with this color. I like it a lot. It's not that big of a deal. Just be careful on the inside. We already painted our skin. You really don't see this part of the shield because it will be really close to the body of the Saurus. But I like to have my things neat and painted. Just be careful coming close to the skin. And there you have it. First layer is finished. Just be really sure to get into all those details. Okay. I already have one almost painted, so I'm going to apply now the second layer. It's precisely the same design, just to give you the idea that two layers are enough to this step. As you can see, the cover is really nice. Again, be careful when getting into the skin. This shield is ready for painting the highlights, and for that I'm going to let this one dry, and we will be doing the first highlights on there. And so as you can see, at this point we have painted all the shields in a Dumbledore Brown. I'm going to highlight them using Tuscor fur. I think I'm going to use the airbrush for this. Let me just simply because it gives a really smooth effect to the transition. We are anyway applying. We are going to apply a layer of shade, so we are going to bring those tones anyway down. Let me grab a brush to transfer the paint. When doing this kind of stuff, I really like to go a little bit with the flow and not to plan much, because I like to use different techniques and also sometimes a mistake can also can also be a good thing, because sometimes as I make a mistake, actually I like the effect that it it's a little bit too thin, a little bit more paint. Okay, let's grab. And so is the effect a little bit smoother, as you can see. Going to grab the I'm trying to highlight the individually those raised areas. I always think that these are scales from a turtle or something like that, or the shell. Yeah, just smoothing a kind of a zenithal highlight, just letting the paint hit the raised areas. And when we are going to shade this, I'm going to play with different colors. So the base color stays the same. That will be Dumble Brown and the score fur. And then we are going now to highlight a little bit further with a little bit of white. And shading the model down, we are going to glaze it. And modify the color that we are going to use on some shields. I'm going to use Agrax Earthshade. On some shields, I'm going to try Reikland Flash Shade. On other ones, I will try Druchy Violet, for instance. I don't know. I'm still looking for the desired effect. I'm going to test on a couple of them. And we will see how it goes. I'm going to finish this off, and we are going further with painting the shields when this is dry. And here I have some tests on some shields, and as you can see, they have different colors. But my mix was with Agrax Earthshade and some Fuegan Orange that I'm going to to use. We're going to use roughly 3 kind of eyeballing that stuff. 2-1. 3-1. Get like a nice mix, and you just go and apply to the shield. that brings a little bit that orange tone from the Dumbo brown to the shields, and breaks a little bit that pinkish tone from the Tuscorphur. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. Just play around with the wash, don't let it pull too much, but if it does, it's not a big of a deal. And we are going just to around all the scales on this shields. And more than this, it doesn't add to it. And when this is dry, I'm going to work on the highlights. That will be on the next video, because otherwise they get too big. And I hope you enjoyed this one. And we will see us in the next one, next video. And I hope you... it's a long series, but I prefer to have them small and a little bit of with a chit chat with the camera, than just paint, and yeah, I like to make some contact with if I'm going to speak to the people that are watching the video. I like to chit chat a little bit with you. That's why I make the videos a little bit longer and not only in the painting. But okay, we are going to let this dry, and in the next video I'm going to start the highlights. And I think that in the next video I'm going to paint all the details on the shields. That be the bone colors, the gold, and some other decorations. So we are going to wrap the shields up, and we can proceed with the rest of the details on the models, and especially with the banner, because I want to make a video on this one. And then we are going to wrap this unit up, and we'll be finished. So thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next one.